thank you very much. So yeah, surprise, surprise, I'm the hacker. I don't look like a hacker, I guess, because I'm not wearing a hoodie. Yeah. I also don't wear gloves when I'm working on my notebook, and I'm also not wearing a ski mask when I'm working on my notebook. Okay. So, but I still think that I'm a good representative for hackers. Because we are also not evil guys. Yeah, we are actually, most of us are very good guys, and we are really trying to use our skills, like understanding the digital world and maybe the internet a little bit better than other people do, and use them for good. Yeah. And the ideas we have, especially the ones with the largest impact, they really change the world. They protect us, our digital profile, our digital privacy, and provide security, which is actually, or should be actually, the fundament of the digital world. Ideas with the largest impact are also not always legal, yeah, and brings the hackers into the prison. And this is, of course, something we don't want. Yeah. So 99% of us are actually nice guys, and we don't want to go to the prison. And now I tell you a story about how to actually build a better world, especially a digital world, yeah, providing our privacy, protecting us from really evil better hackers without going into the prison. Yeah. And I'm not talking about being smarter than the police to don't get caught. I mean actually really another strategy, okay? So. the story starts with me, with my person, and a lot of luck I had. I met a very, very nice guy, Professor Christoph Paar. He's now my doctor father, and he gave me the chance to do my PhD here in Bochum. Bochum is actually one of the hotspots in Europe for IT security and crypto. There are more than almost 20 professors in this field. There are more than 100 researchers and very sophisticated and very good hackers here in Bochum. Yeah. It's really a good hotspot. So I got the opportunity and I got the job to do during my PhD to provide strong security for resource-constrained devices. Yeah. Like microcontrollers, like computers, they don't look like computer, but they are almost everywhere. Yeah? In our maybe washing machine, in medical devices, in industrial devices, and this kind of things. And the goal was to use, you know, strong security features knowing from our personal computers and put them into these very small devices. And in cryptology, you have to know that we do all the time more or less the same. So we play a game. Yeah? Playing games is actually nice. Huh? So the one part is developing security solutions, yeah, and the other part is trying to hack it. And of course, the hackers gave back the information what they did, and then the designers are improving everything. And this goes around and around. Yeah? And after a couple of rounds, in this case, I was very lucky because I was more or less at the end of this game. It took for me 4 years, where our group developed a technology which improved current solutions in a way that we can actually apply them on really cheap devices. Yeah. So with this technology, now we thought, okay, this is super nice. Yeah? We can actually put this into the Internet of Things. Yeah, this is something which will change everything. Yeah, in the future, the Internet of Things will be everywhere. Yeah? Everything will be adapted to us. Our coffee machines will be smart for some reasons. Maybe medical devices will be connected automatically to the doctor. Industry will be improved a lot by our more smarter and connected automation system. Artificial intelligence will be connected to all these devices. And actually, the IoT will change our life in the very, very near future. So knowing this, yeah, that everything goes, you know, into these small devices, smart watches and whatever, we know, okay, this is actually something which might really improve the world. Yeah. So we have our world, we have all the hacks every day, and we have now this technology, and with this technology, we will have a better world. Yeah. Our privacy will be protected, we have strong security, and even the cheapest devices, that's it. Yeah. This is a business enabler for the IoT, and we will get like also super rich by improving the world. Yeah. So we felt like the heroes. Yeah. So what we did, actually, we built a team by, of course, hackers, software engineers, people with experience, and started a company. And we got also support from the German ministry, which was very nice and helped us a lot. And this was something we did, and it took about 1.5 years. Yeah, actually, the most complicated part was the team. Yeah, because team means, especially if money is involved, it is complicated to build a team. Yeah, for a company, if friendships are involved, it's something not easy. But 1.5 years later, we developed this research results into a product. So we had a team, yeah, we had the business plan, and we had this product. And now we went to our potential customers and said, hey, here's a product, buy it, it will be improve everything. And they said, actually, you know, security is not the business enabler yet, maybe in 4 years or something. So it's nice, you know, to provide it, but we will do it when the customers are asking us for this. We said, okay, I mean, this must happen like very soon. And they said, yeah, maybe in 2 years, so let's talk in 2 years. But we were not willing to, you know, go back to, or let's say, go to industry, yeah, to Siemens or Bosch, to large companies, and wait for 2 years until our technology get involved. So we ask more people. And ask them, hey, this is a nice technology. Yeah? It will improve everything. You will have an advantage against everyone else. But everyone said, no, not yet, maybe in 2 years. Yeah? So no money, nobody bought it. Some people already left for this reason. But we didn't give up. Yeah? We tried it in more detail. We explained more what we did, what we do. And then there was actually a company which said, okay, I buy this. This is really nice. And we said, okay, cool, super. So we were super happy. And at some point, we asked them why they actually bought it. Yeah. So not directly. We said, so, hey, I know, it's super nice. But what was the main reason you bought it? And they said, yeah. So the main reason was actually security and privacy will be a big thing, but not today, maybe in 2 years. The second thing is that you activate, you have a technology where we can still use our old chips and we can retrofit these chips with this technology. This is also nice. But the biggest thing is actually that your technology protects the privacy with the side effect that the complexity in our product line is reduced. Yeah, and the risk we have during the production is reduced as well. So when we are actually deciding to build a new digital product, we have to put the production people, yeah, on the table and the IT people. And with your technology, you split this in a way which makes the decision very easy. Yeah? And we said, yeah, I mean, this was clear from the beginning, not maybe. So we were very thankful. Yeah, and happy to learn this, so we changed our wording and said, okay, with our technology you can digitalize your product in a way that the complexity is reduced a lot, and by the way you get like really state-of-the-art security and cryptography into your devices. So and at the end we are actually building a better world, but not as a main product, more like as a byproduct. Okay, and I think there are three things to learn in this talk. Yeah, the first thing is that the IoT will come and will change everything. The second thing is that the security in these tiny devices, which will be around everywhere, yeah, need security. And the third thing is maybe that even if you try to build a better world, that you can not do it as your main product, but like on site as a byproduct. Thank you very much.